I'm Rob of Precision Zone, and I'm going to be showing you how to perform a quick static check on Yaskawa's CIMR-E7 series of inverters. So after the drive has been powered off and sitting for some time, we can check the charge lamp and make sure that it is not on, and this verifies that the DC bus has been discharged. But before we proceed any further, we're going to double check that with our digital multimeter. So what you're going to do is place your multimeter in the DC setting, and then we're going to measure across the DC bus to make sure that the DC bus has been discharged, because we do not want an accidental shock performing this test. So we're at the right setting, and we'll take the negative probe and put it on the negative side of the bus and the positive probe, and we're not showing any voltage. So that's a great sign that we can go ahead and proceed. The next test that we're going to perform is a phase to ground test on the inputs and outputs. So let's go ahead and place our meter in the resistance function. And then we're going to find a good ground and check all the inputs and the outputs, making sure that none of them are shorted to ground. So we'll go R, S, and T. And then we'll go U, V, and W. Well, that's great that passed this test. If any of the phases were to ground, that would be an automatic sign that the drive is going to need repaired. Let's move on to the final test, which is performing a diode check on the input and output transistor module. So we're going to go ahead and set our digital multimeter to the diode function. And then we're going to take the positive side of the multimeter and place it on the negative side of the DC bus. And we're going to measure the inputs with the negative side of the digital multimeter between R, S, and T. 0.53, 0.53. Now we're going to go ahead and switch the leads and take the negative probe and put it on the positive side of the DC bus. And then we'll take the positive lead and go between R, S, and T. 0.53. Okay, so that's great. The range is anywhere between 0.2 and 1 volt. But the most important part about this test is making sure that they're balanced across all three phases. So now that we checked the inputs and verified that they're good, let's go ahead and check the outputs and see how they're doing. We're going to do this the same way. Negative probe, positive side of DC bus, measure between U, V, and W, 0.41. Okay, let's go ahead and switch the leads. And then we'll check one more time, 0.4, 0.39, 0.4. On this specific inverter, both of the tests that we performed, it passed. Now, if this is the same case with you and you're still having a problem, please contact us at Precision Zone for more help. Thanks for watching.